Hey Justin, this is step three, actually recording the cylinder. Now I've got all my parameters set, I've got the volume set, I've got the file loaded. So this is being recorded on an original 1903 Edison cylinder phonograph. This is my dedicated 2-minute recorder. Spring driven, completely original. The recorder and driver are my design, but all based on the original Edison equipment. So now what I have to do is carefully line up the recording stylus to make sure we make full use of this cylinder. We're putting 2 minutes and 25 seconds on a 2-minute cylinder. That looks pretty good. Okay, so all the parameters are set. So we start the machine, let it come up to speed, we drop the stylus. As soon as we drop the stylus, the recording begins, and then I'll start the audio file. And as this tracks across the cylinder, you'll actually see it cutting the wax and actually making this recording. So start the phonograph, go over to the end of the cylinder, drop the stylus, the machine's recording, start the file. Alright, we've recorded the cylinder, it's covered with swarf, so we open the end gate, remove the cylinder, and you can see that it's just covered with cuttings. So we blow this all away, and then we just take a little brush, you can see all the grooves. This is a swarf brush. So this is rather crude, but like I said, these recordings are just for you. I'll do some nice ones for the actual archiving. All right, so don't know how well you can see that, but very defined grooves. Let me swing this camera around. Alright. I'm actually shooting this with my iPhone attached to a tripod. Alright. This is the result. So, pretty much documented the entire process from start to finish using one of the original Edison cylinders. So, be a great bit of advertising perhaps to show what it started as and what it winds up as. Just a thought, but anyway, wanted you to see the entire process beginning to end. Like I said, I will set this up and do a nice video of the entire process, the recorder, the shaver, and of course playing back the cylinder. So let me know what you think.